The purpose of correlational studies is to identify the strength and direction of relationships. You can also use them to predict one variable using another variable. So the whole point here is that you're collecting naturally occurring data, and then you're seeing if there's a naturally occurring relationship between two variables or more variables. So for example, I could ask all of you to report on your height, and then I could ask all of you to report on your weight. I'm not changing anything. I'm just asking you to report something that's naturally occurring. And then I can analyze that data and see if there's a relationship between height and weight. So it's a pretty common research method because it's fairly easy to do. It's easy to collect naturally occurring data when you don't have to manipulate anything. It can also be more ethical than experiments. So because I'm not manipulating anything, because I'm not changing anything, a lot of times it's pretty ethical to do correlational studies. However, because I'm not controlling anything, it does not allow me to identify cause and effect. And this is really, really, really important. And we're going to spend some time talking about that. So it is really important that you remember that correlation does not equal causation. Okay, so finding that two variables are correlated does not mean that they cause each other. Let me give you an example and hopefully this will clear it up. Let's say that I find a correlation, so there is a relationship between ice cream sales and shark attacks, such that when ice cream sales increase, shark attacks also tend to increase. Does this mean that ice cream sales cause shark attacks or that shark attacks cause ice cream sales? Well, no. What's happening here is what we call a third variable problem. Even though ice cream sales and shark attacks are related, they're not causing each other. There's a third variable that we didn't take into account that's causing both of them to increase. So in this case, it would be temperature. So when it's hotter outside, ice cream sales increase, but also when it's hotter outside, shark attacks increase because there's more people swimming in the beach. So this third variable, temperature, is actually causing this relationship. And so it's not that ice cream sales and shark attacks are related in a cause and effect kind of way. They just happen to be related in general. But really they're related because temperature causes both of them. So the third variable problem is an extraneous factor, so an outside factor, that might be affecting your variables. Anytime you conduct a correlational study, this is a big worry. You always have to wonder, is there a third variable that's causing this relationship to happen, that can explain this relationship? Let's talk about correlation coefficients. If you've taken stats or if you've taken intro to psych, you've probably talked about this. The correlation coefficient, or your Pearson R, is a mathematical score that represents the strength and the direction of a relationship. So when we do correlational studies, when we do our analysis, this is the number that we're looking for. The correlation coefficient ranges from -1 to +1. If it's a positive number, it indicates that it's a positive relationship, meaning that as one variable increases, the other one increases as well. So they're moving together. It could also mean they both decrease. The important thing there to note is that they're moving in the same direction. Then if it's a negative correlation, so if it's a negative number, that means that they're actually inverse. So as one increases, the other decreases. Okay, so they're not moving in the same direction. It's important to remember that positive doesn't mean good, negative doesn't mean bad. All it does is describe the way that the variables are moving in relation to the other variable. And then the closer your correlation coefficient is to zero, the less likely that there is a relationship. So if you find a Pearson R of zero, it tells you these factors are unrelated, something like IQ and shoe size, for example. So that's the direction of the relationship. If it's a positive number, it tells you there's a positive correlation, the variables move together in the same direction. If it's a negative number, it tells you it's a negative correlation and the variables are inversely related. Now let's talk about the strength of the relationship. The further away a number is from zero, on both sides, positive and negative, the stronger the relationship is. So a value of +1 is the same in strength as -1, because those are the strongest it can be. It's the furthest away from zero. So when you're looking at the strength of a relationship, you're looking at the absolute value. You ignore the sign. So you ignore the positive, you ignore the negative. You only look at the number. And the bigger that number is, the stronger the relationship is. So for example, if I found a Pearson R of negative 0.7, that would be a stronger correlation than a positive 0.3, because 0.7 is bigger than 0.3. So here's an example of what these different kinds of correlations would look like on graphs. Here on the left, you can see this line that slants down indicates a negative correlation. In the middle, we have one that's a zero correlation, so these variables are not related, and you can see that there's not really a trend. You can't draw a line anywhere in there, so that indicates that nothing is really going on. And then on the right, we have a positive correlation, and you can see that you could draw a line that slants up, indicating that both of the variables are increasing at the same time.